Thing is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made into a good action. Either don'ts or do's. Everything becomes actions. If you don't do certain thing, that's a good action. Refraining from something which Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam forbade us, a ma'ruf, a good thing. And everything Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did and advised us to do is a ma'ruf, is a good action, is a good thing. It is not about certain rituals, which are the only thing which are counted as good deed. For example, prayers, fasting, and you know, charity, and other things that we all are quite familiar with and we do. There are many more than that, a lot more than that, and that's where we tend to fail because we don't realize. And then what we have, what happens, and we tend to not engage in those activities, which, albeit at a level very, very simple. At certain point, it becomes so easy to carry out, but we don't do it because we didn't know, and that's why we lose out on so many of those actions. So this is what the topic for the talk today is, inshallah ta'ala. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in the hadith that I mentioned, appeared in Sahih al-Muslim, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "La tahqiranna shay'an min al-ma'roof." Don't take any action from the ma'roof as little or insignificant. Don't belittle any action. Don't consider anything to be insignificant. Even if it is that you look at your Muslim brother with a smiley face. What does it take? Nothing. It's just habit. It becomes like, you know, your intention behind it, that I want to see my Muslim brother with a smiley face. That's it. Smiling at a Muslim, that's enough. That's a good deed. And how many times can you do it? And how many times do we do it? We can do that with the people that we know. If I know you, I can do it. If I don't know you, assalamu alaikum, wa alaikum assalam, move on. And that becomes very much more sort of, you know, as they say, zabte ka ta'allu. The action, the connection is just bookish, official relationship. So you live in this country, I live in this country, look, you come to the masjid, I come to the masjid, that's it. If I want to be a bit more generous, I would just say assalamu alaikum. And if you say it, I would say wa alaikum assalam, that's it, done. No more than that. I don't want to engage with you. I want to be this on my own. And that's a disease. That's a sickness. It is not because we don't know it. I don't mind knowing, not knowing it, because not how would we know everything? There's a lot to know, inshallah ta'ala. But to have the attitude of not engaging with brothers and sisters and community and Muslims and non-Muslim likewise, especially when Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam made it a big thing. In fact, one of the Sahaba asked Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what are the best actions? And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, among others, he mentioned, say salam to those you know and to those you don't know. So, and which is combined with tahajjud. So Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam made a connection, three or four things. He mentioned about feeding people, he mentioned about fasting, he mentioned about staying up, not fasting, sorry, tahajjud. And then he mentioned about this saying salam to those you know and those you don't know. Smiling at someone, what does that mean? It means that you are actually breaking any gap between you and the brother and the person that you're about to meet or you have just met. It just melts down all the ice in between you. It opens up a lot of things. And even the non-Muslim, when you smile at them, if they're scared of your long beard, they'll just see, oh, he's not going to explode now. He's fine. I'm okay. I don't need to worry about that. It just gives them that sense of security if they had any trouble with you. Even if they hate you and you smile like that, they feel, subhanAllah, he's good. He's okay. He's not in a rush. He hasn't got any trouble. He's not going to harm me. He's not going to harm me. And that on its own is a very big security. That is why we are taught to say assalamu alaikum. What does that mean, assalamu alaikum? Although we don't pay too attention, yeah, peace be upon you. What it literally means, you would be, you know, saved from me. The attitude is that, you know what, don't worry, I'm not going to do any harm to you. I'm your brother, I'm your friend, I'm not foe at all, I'm not your enemy at all. You would not be harmed by me. Assalamu alaikum. Blessings and also the safety and the peace from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is upon you. I'm not going to harm you at all. So obviously then you can understand that when you say assalamu alaikum, the next statement is, Where have you been? Why did you not do this to me? Why did you not call me? And why did you not answer my call or whatever to me that you have not done assalamu alaikum? You didn't mean it. You just said it to follow the sunnah. Inshallah, you'll be rewarded for that. But it was not intended because you didn't know why you're saying assalamu alaikum. So you can't say assalamu alaikum and then punch someone. Obviously, that's not safety at all from you. That's completely wrong. Even with your words. So we need to understand why Sharia, or the tenets of Islam, gives us all those fine details about everything that you do in your life. Even going to the toilet. When you go to the toilet, go with your left foot in first. And try to sit, and then you're comfortable. Don't make sure that, you know, make sure that you don't do anything else. Don't even talk. Don't do anything. Get yourself done and come out. And when you come out, what do you say? Ghufranak. Or Alhamdulillah alladhi adhaba 'anil adha wa 'afani. Those dua. You've done something which was your need, but you'll be rewarded for going to the toilet. Just by making those two things. Entering with left foot, coming out with right foot. When you enter, you said, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min al-khubuthi wal-khaba'ith. Following the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Inside, try to cover your head if you could. Coming out with the right foot. Said the dua. That's all it takes. Is it difficult? Very easy. Because we use our tongue day in, day out. All the time. Other than when listening to the talk or khutbah. If it comes. If you just allow everyone to talk, you will see everyone is talking. Even in i'tikaf, you see, in this day and age, people cannot stop talking in i'tikaf. The brothers are in i'tikaf, chit-chatting, talking about deen. Even then, they cannot stop. So it's not that if I don't say Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min al-khubuthi wal-khaba'is, I'll be doing something else. I'm just sorting out my, you know, work or whatever. Some of the main important tasks that I have to do for the day. So that's the time I only got from my room to the toilet. So I can't say Allahumma inni. No, you're using your tongue for many things. And you would do no matter what. So why not use it in a positive way? Because we don't consider it significant. We don't consider it significant. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in this hadith of Sahih Muslim is advising us not to belittle, not to consider anything insignificant from ma'roof. Even if it is smiling at your Muslim brother. He says, smiling at your brother. And there are two readings to it. Imam Nawawi rahimahullah, for one, he would say, it doesn't matter whether they're Muslim or not, they're smiling, that's it. Because they're brothers in humanity, and they're brothers in Islam as well. So whoever, whether you know them or not, just smile. If they're looking at you, you don't have to look at everyone and smile, but if they're looking at you, at least smile at that point. We tend to not smile at those who we know sometimes, because I'm internally not happy. So I don't say, I don't do it like this, because I'm grieved. I've been tortured by my wife, I dare say that, by some words. So, or she asked for something that I can't do, and I've been, like, you know, ripped apart last night. So whatever happened, the effect is this: my face is just giving a clear signal out that, you know what, I'm not happy, don't even look at me. I may bite. So that is very wrong attitude. That is completely wrong attitude. Well, I won't say it's haram, but what I'm saying that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam make it a thing to mention in a hadith that don't belittle it. And here we are in last of my, you know, 30, 40, 50, 60 years of my age, I haven't even thought about that because I'm not interested in what Sharia is about. We don't understand the core principles of Sharia. We sometimes consider it to be, oh, if I've done this much, then I have done something. Really, I've done a good charity. I've done a good project, a program. You know what? I have just done this big whatever. Someone came to Islam through me. That's a good action. Something, oh, tahajjud, I've done for a whole month. You know, I fasted Monday and said, that's a good action. I will belittle all the, there's so many things that we can fill in between. So what happens? Two diseases, two problems happen. For one, we do those big things. As we grow in those actions, we actually grow in arrogance, self-respect. It's called ujub. Ujub is a disease of the heart. Ujub means that you look, well, there are two things. So takabbur and ujub. Takabbur is something, or kibir is something that everyone knows. Kibir is when you consider other to be lower than yourself. So you belittle someone. As Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, al-kibru batarul haqqi wa ghamtun nas. Kibir is that you reject the truth and also look at someone and consider them to be significantly lower than you, in whichever way, in your appearance, in your wealth, in your status, in whatever, in your good deeds. So what happened? The more tahajjud you do, The more righteous action you do, the more you think that you are someone. You have got some status. I'm having this term in the Sunnah of Rasulullah, and none of you have, so I must be better than you. Clearly. That's what comes to the heart. That's what you start feeling. So this action becomes actually a bad action. It's not a good action, because the intention there is not pure. It is there to show off. It is there to consider yourself to be bigger than other or bigger than other. Haram, wrong. No reward. We feel that we've done this many actions, and I'm, you know, gleaning all those good rewards. We're not. We're actually reaping more sort of possible sins. Because the actions done for other than Allah is not accepted. No matter how good the action is. And you know about the three people on the Day of Judgment who will be thrown into the hellfire, the scholar, the person who has done the, he will actually sacrifice, laid his life a shaheed. And the third one was done a lot of charity for the sake of, or for the sake of himself, but he would portray it to be for the sake of Allah. Those are the fantastic actions. In fact, the best action in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Someone who has those roles, a scholar, are just better than anyone else in the whole world. No comparison, other than Sahaba I'm talking about. I'm talking about common people like ourselves. Because these are the Warasatul Anbiya, they are the heirs of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, of the prophets, heirs of prophets. The wara of the waris. Now, but if they have not got their intention right, some of them would just lose it, even at that highest level. Laying your life for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is meritorious. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam actually said, I would like to be killed in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then, summa uhi, that I want to be resurrected again, and then sent back to this world, and then killed again, and then killed, and then resurrected. And he kept saying it. Amazing. So that's the action itself. How big an action. Yet, when the intention is not clear there, then that's it. So we have attitude there. A problem with the understanding and the attitude of Sharia. Whereby we do good deeds. For one, we don't do. We're not bothered. Most of us are completely lazy, couch potatoes, sitting there watching TV, football, whatever. Or 5 days worth of cricket, or 7 days worth of something else. So most of us are like this, astaghfirullah. But those who do good deeds,